When Elliot was born, I was over the moon. I felt so much love inside, I thought I might burst with pride. My own little family had just started to begin, but I never suspected what you would within. You would phone me 30 times a day. If I missed one call, they'd be held to pay. You knew every step that I made and abused everything that I did. I couldn't make my own decisions. I always needed your permission. I couldn't go for a newspaper without you questioning me. Where have you been? Who did you talk to? You were always on my case and expected me to stand there when your hands were raised. If you loved me like you said you did, why did you try to change me? You ordered me to listen to you and to do what you told me to. When Anthony crashed, you spat, "What's all the fuss?" When they phoned from the hospital, you shouted, "What's the rush?" When I came home that night, you questioned where I'd been. You didn't care that my cousin was on a life support machine. When Michael died, the family was crushed. How did it happen? No one could tell us. We were shocked, devastated inside. It's not very nice to watch your whole family cry. I tried to be strong and hold it together. I'd come home, sit with my head in my hands and listen to you shout, "What about me?" I've had to sit on my own to watch TV. Forget about them, I'm your family. But tell me, do you know how it feels? To be dragged out of bed, punched in the face and kicked in the head. To be strangled so tightly you think you're going to die. And headbutted so hard you split open my eye. After a while it becomes everyday life. Do you feel like a man when you beat up your wife? 18 months after we parted, you broke into my house and held me hostage. What makes you think it's normal to behave like this? You were sad and desperate. No. You are pathetic. And now my nightmare is fading, but it's never far away. I am now a stronger person and living for today. You did not destroy me. Now you are not here to accuse me. You can no longer abuse me because I am now free.